Very good morning, all my dear friends who are joining us across India, and a few of them even from other parts of the world. It's a pleasure, wonderful meeting all of you. I hope that yesterday's session added a lot of value, added insights, good number of thoughts for you to discuss and take it to the next level. So yesterday we got started with what I call it as, you know, the driving school class lessons, correct? Where we have to learn inside the classroom and learn some bit of the traffic rules, learn some bit of the basics of how a vehicle works, or, you know, so that you're able to navigate. Today, my dear friends, we are going to discuss what I would probably call it as, how do I get started with my data analytics journey? And the moment we say data analytics, the one thing which is always popular, always commonly heard, which everybody is aware of, is Excel sheet. Many of us, reality is, we have used only a small portion of Excel sheet, very, very small portion. And the most popular thing we use in Excel is sum dal do, calculate kar do, multiply kar do. Do we have something beyond it? That is what my focus today, my dear friends, is, and that is what I want to take you through in today's session. And I have with me a good friend, a mentor, and a wonderful person by heart, CA Manmeet Singh Mehta. All of us popularly call him as Mehta sir. He's from Delhi. He's joined us. So first of all, a very warm welcome to you, sir, from our side. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining. We hope that this webinar will add a lot of practical, valuable insights with your presence. And on that note, I'll quickly introduce sir to get started with it. Sir, if you could just move to the next slide. Yeah. So sir has about 30 years of experience in management consulting, professional audit and tax practice. And he has a good amount of management system control and assurance. He's a management system controls assurance professional, conducted various trainings on IT strategy, application, operation and resources. He is a visiting faculty for the DISA course, which is hosted by our ICAI, FAFD course by our ICAI. We have the data analytics workshops, which is done across India. He again does a lot of data analytics workshops as well, and concurrent audit course. So all of these things are a few areas where he does. And sir always says he's very hands-on, more than theory. So that is something which I really like. And he's of course passionate about data and analytics. He's by qualification FCA, CISA, CISA and CFE. So with this brief background, I would present to you, sir. Sir is also speaker in various forums of technology, computerized auditing and audit tools. So I would request sir to take over from here, where he will take you through the so-called journey of Excel. I will be slightly on the backseat today, but I will be keep on coming frequently, just to ensure that, you know, all of us are engaged and connected so that we are able to have an interactive session. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. So, a very good morning, friends. Every data piece has a story to tell. And data analysis is nothing, how you make the data tell the story. So, it's all a story, you know, we'll be talking about. This story starts in year 2021. COVID impact has reduced. We are talking about a story which is somewhere in the future. And in the past, you know, in the last year, in year 2020, there was an outbreak of COVID and there was a big lockdown, which continued for months altogether. So it was a disruptor in terms of technology, in terms of upgradation. And the company I consult to, they asked me that how should we proceed? And based on the recommendations, they went to work from anywhere. They shifted to the cloud and all the cloud tools. But now, after 1 year, they want to assess what has been our usage of data across various units, across, you know, various months, so that they could take an efficient and effective data plans, again, to minimize expenses or optimize expenses, I'll say. So friends, every data analysis story starts with a business question. Okay. In this case, the business question is, since we have gone online, we've moved to the cloud. Okay. And we are using all cloud-based applications, our data is in the cloud. So that uses a lot of data. We'll be needing a lot of data. So the point my organization now asks me is, what has been my data consumption? And we want insights into it so that we can optimize and perhaps reduce our expenditure for the future. So for every business question to answer, we need some kind of data. So the next step is we'll be taking some kind of data. That would be the first step in the story. After getting the data, which could be from various reports, from various different sources, you could be getting the data. But data never comes clean. Okay. You'll have to somehow clean the data. Friends, there is nothing like a perfect data which you'll be getting. All the time, the data you'll be getting, you'll have to clean it. You'll have to do some processes on that, so that it becomes able to tell you a story. Okay, so that process of cleaning has to be done for any kind of data which you get. Because I often say perfect data, perfect situations, and perfect spouse, they never exist, right? So everywhere we have to make some compromises, we have to, you know, innovate something, right? Once you clean the data, next is, now you get insights from the data. You start analyzing the data. Various steps you could take again to analyze the data. And the last is, now data tells its story. Okay. You'll be taking the findings, you'll be presenting those findings. Now, friends, in all these steps, one tool which is of immense use is MS Excel. MS Excel is a great tool, let me tell you. I generally call it the Swiss Army knife. You know, you can do anything with Excel. You could write reports, you could do an audit, okay? You can get the findings, you can make calculations, you can do whatever you want. It's a very versatile tool. And a must tool, you know, for anybody to use who talks about data. So Excel makes the data tell the story. But the only thing is, we need to have the skills to make the data tell its story. So data analysis is nothing but, you know, the art and science of making the data tell its story, right? So the first step, friends, in any of this story is to get the data, okay? And data, more often than not, you'll be getting in form of some kind of reports you'll be getting, okay? Now, these reports could be from ERP systems. These reports could be from various sources. And when you're talking about Excel, more often than not, you'll be getting reports which are some kind of, you know, data which is of different types. Now, primarily, if I talk about, there are four kind of data types which are there in Excel. First are the text data, which is some kind of characters which are there. And a typical thing about them is they are always, you know, aligned to the left. So typically when you look at it, by sight you can check whether it's text, you know, is by aligning it on the left. But yes, alignment can be changed, right? The second type of data you'll be getting is some kind of numbers, okay? Numeric data is more often than not aligned to the right. And then we'll also be getting, date data. Now, date data inherently is numbers, okay, which are presented as dates. And they often would be, again, you know, some kind of right aligned. Now, let me talk a bit about dates. See, Excel knows nothing about dates. Its internal engine is working on numbers. So again, at the back end of every date would be a number, okay? Now, that number is a number. Days elapsed since 1st January 1900. So if you put a date which is, you know, prior to that, Excel doesn't understand that. So that's why number calculations and date calculations are easy for Excel in the sense, because it knows only numbers. So the third kind of is date. And the fourth is the Boolean data. The Boolean is true and false because a lot of operations work in the form of true and false. Okay. So Boolean is that true and false statements and used in lot of different logical operations like AND operation, IF operation, OR operation. So some kind of Boolean logic would be used. So these are the four primary data types you have. Okay. Now the data I'll be getting, the data I'll take for, you know, this exercise is some kind of a text data. Okay. Now this text data is the, see, this client has got various units. Okay. On all these units, there has been some data consumption. Okay. So these are the dates. These are the serial number of the records. And this is the amount of data used by this unit by, let's say, the unit 3 on 24th March 2020. Okay. Since we are talking about 2021, coming to this story in 2021. So this is the data which they have used, you know, during the prior year. Now this is the data we want to analyze to look at the trends of consumption of data. Okay. Now, this whole data, you know, I take to Excel. So let me copy this whole data. Okay. Now, in Excel, if I want to operate, what I'd want is to convert those text to columns. Because when I talk of Excel, in Excel, the data has to be in some kind of rows and in some kind of columns. Now, when I take this kind of a data to Excel, okay, rows will come automatically. There is no issue about rows because when the data is in text format, it's already in rows. But the big issue is how to tell Excel where the first column ends and the second starts, where the second field ends and the third field starts. Okay. So we need some way of telling Excel that how to segregate the data into different columns and different fields. Now, Excel uses two techniques for this. One could be delimited. Now, delimited means where each of these fields is limited by some character. Now, that character could be a space, that character could be a comma, okay? That character could be any character, okay? So, delimited data means where every field has got a delimiter or some kind of field limit, which is through some ASCII character, okay? It could be a space because space also has got its own ASCII number, okay? The second means is something called as fixed width. Okay, fixed width is where every column has got a fixed width. Fixed width means the first column could be 10 characters, the second could be 30 characters, the third could be 8 characters. So that means whatever is within those 10 characters or 30 characters, that goes into one column. So primarily there are two methods. One is called a delimited and other is called a fixed width. Now, Excel mostly on its own gets to know whether it's a fixed width data or it's a delimited data. 99.9% of the times, Excel itself can guess whether it's a delimited data or some kind of a fixed width data. And you can continue with that. In case you want to change, yes, there is an option to change. Okay. So let's see how we can take this data to Excel. Okay, now what I'll do is, I have an Excel sheet where I'll be pasting this whole data. But this data, you know, is not capable of being analyzed as it is. Because everything is just in one column. We got a serial number also. We got the unit number also. We have the date also. Okay, we got the consumption of data also. All of them are in one column. Now to segregate them, the first thing we'll be doing is we'll be, you know, going to data. In the data tab, there is an option of text to columns. Okay, so in data tab, there is an option of text to columns. Now, if I just click on that, this is the same screen which I just showed you. And it shows that, you know, there are two kind of things. One is a delimited, other is a fixed width. And if you look at it, Excel itself has seen that this is some kind of a fixed width data. Okay. Now to segregate it, taking it forward, now this wizard in three steps can convert any kind of text into Excel. Okay. Now, going next, there are three things, you know, to create a break line. Wherever you want to create a break line, you need to click. To delete a break line, double click. To move a break line, pick and drag. So these are the three steps which you need to segregate data into different columns. Okay. Now here, if you look at it, Excel itself has marked two breaks. But if I go a bit down, what I'll find is, you know, this is breaking the whole serial number into two parts. So what I'll do is I'll just come here. Once I select this, if you see, the line is a bit lengthened. Wherever you select a field break, the line is a bit lengthened. So just double click and that line is gone. So the first field break comes. But friends, for the next field break, the problem is data is not in proper columns. Data is not in proper columns. So taking this kind of thing, if I introduce some kind of a break, okay, then the problem is my data would be broken into different columns. Okay, now to have this thing, what I'll do is right now I'll just make it into two columns. The first is the serial number and second is the consumption. Now I'll go to next, okay, and finish. Now my whole data is broken into two parts. One is the serial number, other is the units and their respective consumptions. Now, but this whole thing, you know, still doesn't make any sense, because if I want to analyze, I'd want a unit-wise, date-wise data consumption. Now, this kind of a unit-wise, date-wise data consumption could be done. Now, everything else could be done using something we refer to as cleaning the data. Somehow we'll have to clean the data. As you see here, there is no perfect data. Somehow we need to segregate into different units. We need to segregate into different dates. We need to segregate into some kind of columns. Okay, so we need to do these things. So this process, friends, is data cleaning. Okay, so the next step is we'll be cleaning the data. Now for cleaning this kind of a data, Excel is very, very helpful, let me tell you. And we'll be looking at various Excel functions or Excel functionalities which could help you clean the data. And today, one of the foremost is something called as Flash Fill. Now, Flash Fill is a wonderful option which has come in Excel versions 2013 and above. The prior versions don't have this version. Now, one thing which is sure is, friends, Excel with its latest versions is bringing a lot of artificial intelligence, a lot of machine learning which is coming into it. Now, it can automatically sense what you want to do. And Flash Fill is one such function which tries to guess what you want to do and basically replicates whatever you have done. So it, you know, works like a monkey. It just repeats what you have done. It tries to understand your logic and replicates the same logic. So there is some amount of machine learning, AI, and all those things which are involved in the use of Flash Fill. And I can surely tell you, if you go with the latest versions like Office, MS Office 365 and all, they've got plenty of AI built into them and make your work lot easier. Okay. Friends, one thing I'll surely say is we have to learn to invest on technology. And I can tell you one thing, this investment in technology with the latest tools can give you very good dividends, right? The second thing, you know, we'll be discussing is how we can trim the data. See, a lot of times, you know, there are extra spaces within the data. If you are using something like VLOOKUP, which wants the exact thing as it is, so these extra spaces can be removed using the trim function. There are many, many more functions within Excel which are similar functions. Okay, then we'll also be looking at how we can sort the data. Okay, sorting is a very important step as far as analyzing the data is concerned. Then you could select the data according to any of your criteria using filters. And friends, honestly telling you, I have been using Excel since perhaps last more than 20 years. Okay. One function which I found evolved perhaps with every version of Excel is filters. Filters has grown a lot, from the one we used to have long back in the initial versions of Excel. And every version of Excel brings some kind of enhancement in that. So today, if you look at filter, it's a very, very powerful function as far as, some kind of analysis is concerned. And then we look at also that star function of Excel, which is VLOOKUP. Okay, with VLOOKUP, you can find something and, you can have a result somewhere else also. So you could look up for something and have the results, have the outputs. Okay, so we'll be looking at these functions and how these functions in Excel can help us clean the data. So coming back to my data, now my data is in two parts. Now the problem is, if you look at it, is not structured the same. Okay, now here it is three unit, which is basically five characters, but here it is 12 unit, which has got six characters. Similarly, spacings are different. Similarly, other things are different. Now if I want to clean the data, as I said, we got a wonderful function which is called flash fill. Now flash fill, you have to teach Excel. You have to give the logic to Excel. What do I really want to do? Now what I want is, I want to extract the unit number out of this whole data. Okay, so what I'll write is 3 unit. This is the third unit of the client. Okay, it has got around 12 different units. So this is the third unit, right? Now, as soon as I tell Excel that please segregate third unit out of this whole data, and just one click, my job is done. That is the power of AI, friends. Now, Excel thinks that the logic it is replicating is, now Excel thinks that this person is trying to extract whatever is in front of a space. Whatever is in front of a space, so this person is trying to extract that. Okay, and with a single click, it does it. All right, friends, I've used the function which is called flash fill. Now flash fill works with Control E is a shortcut, so that's the shortcut I've used. Since you can only see my screen, you can't see how I'm working on my keyboard. On my keyboard, I'm using some kind of shortcuts here, and Control E is a shortcut for flash fill. Okay, now next I tell it, I want the date. Okay, so date also I put in, and I say I want this date, and again this time let's use the flash fill. So I'm using a flash fill. Now it has given me some dates, but do you think it is acted correctly? Obviously no, because rather than 20, here it has brought 202. Now again, here it is again 202. Here it has missed out it altogether. So we'll have to train it now. We'll have to train it. Okay. So I tell it, okay, the next figure is 15th August 2020. Okay. That exactly whether it is 2020. I mean, say which of these 20 represent the two parts of YY, and which of these So perhaps it is failing somewhere. Okay. That is why it's having a bit of problem. Let me do one thing just to show you flash fill. What I'll do is, I'll just change the data a bit. I'll just change from 2020, because it is facing some problem. It's not able to understand which is the first part of this year and which is the the other part of the year. I'll just change 2020 to 2019. That way I think so you'll be able to get an idea of how you can used at all. Okay, so I'll just okay, so 24th March 2019, okay, 15th August 2019, and then control D. Now it's able to get all the dates. So there, you know, it was facing a bit of problem. It's not able to understand which was the first part of those, you know, four in the year. Now, if you look at it, now it has done, you know, perfectly. Okay, it has perfectly segregated the data. The third is, you know, what I do is 0.384. So I just give it a number and I say, okay, flash fail. So it gives me all the numbers also. Now, what I've got is I've got the unit. Okay, I've got the date and I've also got the consumption, right? What I've done is I've cleaned the data. So I've cleaned the data using those three things, okay? Using a simple function, which is flash fill. And flash fill is, you know, helps whether it's a huge data, you can do it very quickly. So it understands your logic and tries to replicate it, okay? Now, what I'd also want is, apart from date-wise, I'd also want to look at the trend, you know, which is on various days, okay? I want to know, whether it's a Sunday or a Monday or a Tuesday. So what is the consumption across various days of the week? Okay. Now, to get the days of the week, we'll use a function which is called text. Okay, so it converts it into a day. So I just use this to convert whole of this into a date and I paste it as a special. Okay, so now I got a day of the week also. What I've done is I've taken the data, I've cleaned the data using flash fill, I've segregated it into 3-4 columns. I've also calculated the day of the week for that for those specific dates. Okay, now we've seen two functions. One is a flash fill, other is how we can use a text function. Now, what I'd want is, I'd want somehow to get the name of the unit also here. Now, name of the unit, if you look at, is in a different sheet, where unit one is acting tablets, unit two is manufacturing some kind of capsules, unit three is hormones, and I mean, just so on and so forth. So the function we can use is called VLOOKUP. Now, VLOOKUP is a function. Narasimhan, can we have the video also, I mean, say, so that I can explain it. They could see me and, you know. Okay. See, now VLOOKUP is a function, you know, which has got four inputs. First input is, what do you want to find? Second is, where do you want to find it? And the third is, which column you want the result to come from? And fourth is, do you want an exact result or approximate result? So it's got four inputs, what to find, where to find it, where do you want to get the results from, and do you want exact results or approximate results? Okay, so these are the four inputs which go into VLOOKUP and then you get the results. Okay, so I'll use VLOOKUP is equal to VLOOKUP. Okay, now VLOOKUP says, first is lookup value. The lookup value in very simple terms is what to find. Okay, then it says table array. Now table array is where to find. Okay. Then it says column index number. Column index number means which column you want the result to come from. Okay. So which is which. And the third is the range. The range here means whether you want an exact result or an approximate result. That means what? That means Do you want a true or a false? How do you want the result to come? Okay, so I'll just make it as how. So it is four parts: what to find, where to find, where do you want the result to come from, do you want exact results or approximate results. Okay, so those are the four things which would be required. Okay, so let me replace it with the things. The first is what to find. Okay, now I'll replace it with a unit. Now this is I want the name of this unit. I don't want a 3-unit, 4-unit. I want the name of the unit so that I can at a glance guess my tablet unit is using more data, or my capsules unit is using more data. So what I want is the name also to be there. Okay, then it says where to find. Now where to find is would be this array. I want the result from here. Okay, between column A and B. Okay, now it says which column do you want the result to come from. Now which here means which column do I want the result to come from. I want it to come from, this is one column, this is two column. One thing to remember is it always has to be a number. This is column one. So how do we really find it? We find like this, 1, 2. So I want the result to come from column 2. Now then it says, how do you want the result? So here if you look at, it says range lookup, and range lookup could be true or false. True means a 1, means approximate match, and 0 means false, which means an exact match. In this case, I'd want an exact match. So I'll put in a 0, okay? Because 0 indicates an exact match, false. Okay, so I'll just click on this, and what I get is this is unit hormones. Okay, so what I get is the name also here. Okay, so what I got is hormones. So just double click on hormones, I copy it all across. Now I get all the names, but in some cases you find something comes which is NA. Now NA means what? NA means it has not found it, it's an error. Now, but the question is, why is there an error? Here it is written unit 7. And here also it is unit 7. And it has not brought in infusions. Okay? It has not brought in infusions. Now, the reason could be, as I said, there could be empty spaces there. Okay? Excel doesn't, for Excel, they both are different. If there are two empty spaces there or two blanks there, right? For Excel, it is not same. It will look at exactly the same data. So one function which is used again to clean the data is trim function. Now trim, what it does is it cleans the data. Wherever there are empty spaces, it just removes those empty spaces. And in between two characters, if there are more than one empty spaces, you will just keep one. So trim is used again to cut or to clean the data. All right. So I'll use a trim function. Okay, sorry. So I'll use the trim function, okay? And what I get is a unit. I just copy it and I will paste special here, okay? Now friends, when I come here, you see all of them have come, okay? So we have one more function, which is a trim function. Now trim function is used to, clean the data, okay? Remove the empty spaces. Now, mostly if you look at, we got our data, we have the unit number now in place, we have the date in place, we have the consumption pattern in place, okay? We have the day also of the week, and we have the name of the unit also. So I don't need this basic one, so I can just delete this data. So basically, I now have a clean data, which I can now work. Now, one thing which you could use again to have some sense of the data, to understand the data, is you could use a function which is called sort. Now, sorting is available in data. It's available in data tab. And in data tab, here you got the function of sorting. Okay. Now, for sorting, to function well, we need to remember a couple of things. First is a data headers should be in one row. Okay, preferably in one row and preferably in bold. You know, that way Excel understands that these are headers. Now, second thing to remember is that there should be no blank row. There should be no blank row, you know, within your whole data, and there should be no blank column also, because Excel considers them to be end of the array markers. Okay. So once these things are okay, if I just go to data and I go to sort, I just selected one cell, mind it. I've just selected one cell. My data is formatted properly. Now what Excel will do is it will select it all properly. And here it says my data has headers. Okay, it says my data has headers. And if you look at it, now you can sort according to serial number rather than those, you know, clumsy column A, column B, column AIA, and then you go and look for what is there in column AIA or something. So this is much more efficient, okay? Much more useful way of doing it, where you could save on time, you could do a better analysis, okay? So you could do sorting, friends, by any means, okay? You can sort by values, okay? You can sort by values, you can even sort by colors. If there are colors, you can sort by colors. If there are font colors, you can sort by font colors. So all these facilities are available with which, you know, you can sort it. So perhaps what I'll want to do is I want to sort it based on the date, okay? From oldest to the newest date, okay? So my data is sorted, okay? From earliest date to the last dates, okay? Now, another thing we'll be looking at is how we can filter the data. Now, to filter the data, I'll go to filter option. Now, this is the filter option. It's again within the data tab. The shortcut is Alt-AT. I would say shortcuts are pretty easy way of doing it. But you need to have to develop the hang of using those, okay? So what I'm doing is I'm just putting up a filter. The filter, as I said, is a very, very powerful feature today. Apart from other things, you will also find that, you know, you got these kind of filters also. If you want to look for just one quarter, so you could go to, you know, this quarter, the previous quarter, the next quarter. Okay, so based on your date, you know, you could find even, you know, according to different quarters or years or months. Okay, so it's a very, very, it is a very evolved function, you know, as compared to earlier times. Then data, if you look at, in numbers also you look at, you got plenty of new features like equals to, does not equal to, more than, less than. And, you know, we got these new features, which is top 10. You want to know those top 10 entries, you know, top 10 data usages, you know. So you could guess which date and which unit there had been a maximum usage on one day. Okay, so we got these top features. Okay. Now, similarly, a very powerful is the, you know, above average. So above average could give you all those cases where the where, you know, on certain dates, the data usage has been more than average. So that could also give you a lot of insight into the consumption of data. Okay. So filtering, friends, is a very, very powerful function we have. Okay. So friends, in the process, what we have had look at, we have had a look at, you know, the flashful function. We had a look at how we can trim the data, how we can you know, use sorting, how we can filter the data, okay? And we also had the look at how we can look up for some value, okay, in a different array, maybe in a different table altogether, maybe in a different workbook altogether, okay? So you know, that was a bit of how you can clean the data. And in the process, we've learned about how we can use flashfill, how we can trim the data, how we can sort the data, how we can filter the data, and how we can use some kind of a VLOOKUP. Okay. Now, after you've cleaned the data, you'll be analyzing the data to get some insights out of the data. Okay. So the next step is we'll be analyzing the data. Now, to analyze, a few of the features we'll explore is, we'll be looking at how table is a wonderful feature we have within Excel. And you can do a lot, you know, using simple tables. It makes your job much, much more efficient. Then we'll be looking at one star function of Excel, which is called pivot tables. Okay. Pivot tables, let me tell you, is a very, very powerful feature. One of the, I'll say,
most powerful feature, I'll say, within Excel. Okay, and then you can slice the data using slicers. Okay, so let's come back to the data to see how these features work. Okay, now first is I'll just, you know, remove the filters. Okay, and my data is sorted. Okay, so just to get insights. Now the next thing I'll be doing is I'll be showing you tables. The table is one functionality within Excel which is very, very powerful. Okay, now for example, what we do is, as we, you know, just scroll across, what you'll find is, I don't know what is this value, is it a day or what? What is this? We don't know the headers. What is this? Again, from this data, we don't know. So the way out is, we'll have to somehow freeze this. Okay, only then the things would work. But come tables. Tables are available in insert. I can make it out to be a table, or the shortcut is Control T. Okay, it's written out here. So I could use the shortcut and just make it out to be a table. Okay, and as soon as I click on it, you see it's converted into table now. And here you could give the name of a table also. I can name it as consumption. It's my consumption table, right? So the beauty of table is, number one, automatically data is filtered. Second is, banding takes place automatically, so makes the things much, much easier to see and read. So your readability improves. And then, you know, you got an option, you know, where you could even, you know, design it differently. So you got a built-in, you know, whatever Sabya Sachi Mukherjee or whatever you call it. So, you know, mere wala yellow, ya mere wala orange, ya mere wala green. You can take it in whatever mode you want. Okay. So it's got those built-in color options. It's got, so it helps, you know, whether different tables, you could just color them differently. So instantly you'll recognize this is the consumption table, this is some other table, this is unit table. So makes the job much, much easier. Okay. So any of these we could take, right? So now we got table. And the second benefit of table is, now just have a look. As I start scrolling, you see it, my headers rather than ABC become what? The headers of the table. So I could go, you know, to 8,000 rows. I don't need to freeze the top. It automatically becomes my headers. Okay. So when you scroll across large sheets, it's a pretty handy function to have. So at all times, you know, this is a small table. Sometimes you got, you know, tables which are spanning across so many different columns. So makes the job easier. Anywhere you are within the data, you get to know what the headers are. Okay. You can explore those headers. Okay. And on top of that, you know, for table, you know, you could automatically get a total row. Okay. I just click on total. So what will happen is, it's automatically taken the total of this consumption. Okay. Because that is one numeric which is here. So it is automatically taken the, it has, okay, but I could also take it as a count or something. So means point is, I can change those things. Those things come automatically. Okay, that is, friends, the power of tables. Okay, once we explore the tables, look at the power, you know, calculations are easy. Adding new columns, adding new data is much, much easier in tables. So plenty of features you get inbuilt, you know, into tables. Our table is a very, very powerful feature, but let me tell you again, you know, very few people have found, you know, using tables, although it's a very, very powerful tool we have. Now, friends, we come to one, I'll say, star tool of Excel, which is called pivot tables. And pivot table option you have in insert. Okay, insert, you can create pivot. Now, pivot is what? Pivot is around which something can move. It is the axis around which something can move. In this case, you can spin the data, you can move the data. Okay. Now, this, I got this basic data. I want to create a pivot out of this. Okay. So as soon as I go to it, okay, it has selected the whole data and it wants to take it to a new worksheet. So let's go to a new worksheet. So I click on OK. So as soon as I click OK, my headers, they become my table fields. So I can create a pivot based on any of these. Okay. No, I could make a simple table. I could say, okay, units at the consumption. See, in one click, I have got the unit and their relative consumptions. Okay, so I got consumptions for all of this. Okay, so I got unit as well as the consumption. Okay, now I can spin the data. Okay, so I don't want unit. I just unclick, I'm back. Now what I want is a day-wise consumption. I don't want a unit-wise consumption. I want a day-wise consumption. So on Monday, my consumption is this. Tuesday, my consumption is this one. Wednesday, my consumption is this one. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So what I got is consumptions. Okay. Now, I also want to have a look at date-wise consumption. So I just take it across. Okay. I can have a date-wise consumption. Okay, so now I'm having a date-wise consumption. So which day, which consumption across all these units. So what I just done is summarize the data according to my criteria. I want a day-wise consumption, I want a month-wise consumption, I want a date-wise consumption, I want a unit-wise consumption. It can give me whatever I want. And that too at a click of a button. I didn't use any function, I didn't use any kind of a formula. I just spin the data, right? Spin the data, have a multi-dimensional view of data. So what I'm doing is I'm just spinning the data. I'm just changing the perspective. So each of these perspective will tell me a different story. So pivot is a very, very essential function when you talk of data analysis, because pivot makes the data tell a story. And data analysis is nothing but a story, right? It's a story which the data tells you. So now I can also take it in a different form. I don't want a date-wise function. I want what is my month-wise consumption. Okay. So just click on this. I right-click. Okay. Now what I'll do is I'll just group it. I want to do a monthly grouping. And I click OK. And voila. Now what I've got is month-wise consumption just with one click. I don't need to sort, I don't need to total something, I don't need to do all those things. Just one click, another view. So what I'm doing is I'm again spinning the data. Okay, I'm having multi-dimensional view of data. I can tabulate the data, I can cross tabulate the data. So not only I can have kind of a vertical data, I just take this date to columns. Now what I got is a horizontal data also. Now when I'm at columns, I also want at the same time, I want to know what for each of these months, what is my date-wise, my day-wise consumption. So at the same time, what I can do is I can bring day to row. And wow, what I've got is month-wise as well as day-wise. So both ways I've got the consumption. Now with one click I've got date-wise as well as month-wise consumption. Okay, now see, this is what how data tells its story. What was raw data, all those columns were different, had some kind of numbers. Now they are telling a story. On Monday in January, this was the consumption. In February, this was the consumption. March, this was the consumption. So on different days, on different months, what is my consumption? Now a story is beginning to form. Okay. Data is trying to now tell its story. Okay. Now what I want is, I also want to know unit wise. So I could take the unit to filter. Okay. And now I want to know what is the data consumption for just unit 10. Okay. Now this is unit 10. Okay. I want to know what is it for unit 2. Okay. So this is unit 2. But again, remembering unit 1, unit 2, that is tough for me. So I say, okay, I don't want a unit. Okay. Rather than that, what I'd want is, I'd want a name of the factory or the name of the unit. Okay, now I get to know for my capsule unit, what is the data consumption? I will say, I think so, you get the point. You can spin the data. You can tabulate the data. You can cross-tabulate the data. You can make it tell whichever story you want. You want a unit-wise story, fine. You want a name-wise story, again, it is fine. You want a day-wise story, again, it is fine. You want a month-wise story, again, it is fine. Okay. So that is the power of pivots, friends. You can make any kind of a data tell a story. Okay. Now, I'll again, you know, remove name. Okay. And I got a data which is pretty long. So let me now spin it. My day comes here and my date comes here. A different view, a different perspective, a different way of interpreting it. Okay. And then, friends, we got a wonderful feature once I'm on pivot. Okay. This is the pivot table analyze feature. And we got a wonderful feature which we have now is slicers. Not only I can pivot the data, I can slice the data the way I want. Okay. So I just click on slicers. So what I want is a name by slicer. Okay. I want a name of the factory. Okay. So what you find is, now rather than filters, I've got this slicer now. Okay. I can slice the data the way I want. I want only results relating to beta lactam. Done. Only beta lactam. Okay. I want the results only for the capsule unit. One click. Done. Now, you see that data which was in very crude form. Okay. The data which was in very crude form, it has started telling you a story. So that crude data which was in some kind of a text file, if we have cleaned the data, we have made the data tell a story. And using a simple tool, which is Excel. Okay. Say I want a enzymes data. So this is data relating to enzymes. Okay. This is related to herbals. Okay. I want everything. Okay. Everything. This is my whole consumption across the months, across the days. Okay. So you can spin the data. You can make the data tell its story. So friends, these are two features, which is a slicer and a pivot. Okay. Now continuing. Now continuing the story. Okay, once you've analyzed the data, now the next step is you need to present the findings. Okay, once you've made up a story, you've understood the story, you've analyzed the things. Okay, now you need to present that story. Now you got to tell the story to the management. Okay, and this is where, you know, visualizations come into play, or some kind of dashboards will come into play. Because visualization and dashboard is the best story you can tell. Dashboards and visualizations is the best story you can tell the management. They are easier to grasp rather than those, you know, sanitized numbers. Numbers are, you know, makes it easier to make it, makes numbers, only plain numbers make it difficult to understand. Whereas visuals are easier to understand. Okay. So let's now see how we can present our findings. Okay. Now, in pivot, if you've got a wonderful thing, which is called pivot charts. Okay. A wonderful thing, which is called pivot charts. With the help of pivot charts, you can visually present the data. You can visually present the data the way you want. Okay. Now you would have different kind of charts. You could have a column chart. You could have a line chart. You could have a pie chart. You could have a bar chart. Okay. I would say any kind of thing. Okay. Cluster chart, scatter plot. So all these different histograms and, you know, box and whiskers, all these different charts are there. So if I just take a column chart. Now the story is good, Okay, it is telling me the story which is in, you know, it is telling me the story which is there and different, but this story is a bit difficult to understand. Okay, this story is becoming a bit difficult to understand. Now, friends, the power is that not only this one, you can also change it. You can change the story, you can change the design. Okay, you can change the chart type too. In this case, I feel line chart could give you a better story, which is now easier to understand. Now you are seeing the trends. You are seeing the trends across January to, you know, December. And you are seeing, you know, that this is the data usage in January and this has gone to April and, you know, has peaked in July and then it is coming down. So friends, this is the story I'm talking of. Okay. Now, let me minimize a bit because, you know, it's taking a lot of place, and let me move it a bit on my screen. Okay. Now you're seeing the story, right? Now you are able to see a story now. It is showing the consumption. So what was raw data is now telling a story in the forms of peaks and troughs. So all those peaks and troughs are there. You can see a story. It's for different days. Okay, for Monday it is different, for Tuesday it is different, for Wednesday it is different. And friends, this story needs to be interactive also. Needs to be interactive also in the sense that whatever story you want related to whichever unit you want, you should be able to, you know, get it. Okay, now let's see how we already have interactivity involved because we have implemented slicers also. So I want to know the story for beta lectum. This is the story for beta lectum. I want to know the story for capsules. This is the story for capsules. This is the story for enzymes. So this is, friends, what all these dashboards are. You could see all your KPIs just at one place. And that too, very interactively, it can change according to perspective. It can change according to needs. I want herbals. Okay, this is herbals. This is hormones. This is infusions. This is injections. This is liquids. These ointments. Okay, I want for my entire factory or my entire organization. This is the one. Friends, as I said, data analysis is nothing but a story. And Excel has got plenty and plenty of tools which can help you build that story. We have just seen a fraction of the capabilities Excel has. Okay.
Yeah, sorry, friends. I think there was some connectivity issue. Now you can hear us.
Okay. So I was at the last part of the whole thing. That was the presentation of those findings. Okay. That was in the presentation of those findings. Now, the story is for the basic question, the business question which was there. And the business question was the data requirements of the organization. Now, by analyzing the data, now I can answer the question that we got peaks which are in January, April is a bit lean, and there are peaks which are at June and July. Now, the organization, something to optimize the expenditure relating to data. Now it knows. Once that insight is there, once that knowledge is there, now the organization can plan its strategy, it can plan its resources according to, you know, the requirement. Okay. So, friends, that was where I thought, you know, I could just tell you about how Excel can help you out. And we have seen that it can get that, it can help you getting the data into Excel, some kind of a text file. It can also help you in cleaning the data using various Excel functions. You can clean the data, okay, make it into a recognizable, analyzable form. And let me tell you, this is one of the toughest parts. Cleaning is a tough part, right? After cleaning, you know, the next part arrives is how you analyze the data. Now, analyze the data to look at various trends which could be there, okay? So using pivots, using tables, we could have a look at the data. Okay, we could have a look at, you know, how we can spin the data according to months, according to days, according to units. We can spin the data. Once we get the trends, once we analyze the data, then we need to tell the story to the management. Then we need to tell the story to the management. And for presentation, visualization is some of the best tools you could have, because a picture is worth 1,000 words, right? So you could have 1,000 figures. They won't give the management such a perspective which a visual could have. Okay, so pivot chip, you know, the dashboards using slicers, pivot charts is a great way of presenting the data to the management. So friends, that was a bit about, you know, this whole thing. Okay, the story of data analysis, right from business question and answering those questions. So, you know, I had some, you know, 1 hour and 10 minutes. That was the time, you know, which was cool to me. So any questions? I think so. Narasimhan is there to moderate, and anything you wish to know.
Sure. Thank you so much for this wonderful session. You kept it simple and you were able to add a lot of thoughts. I think many of them found it very handy, especially that flash fill and the way the data is sorted, because many a times we get stuck. Okay, I have to manually sit and type, etc. So you clarified that flash fill. I think that was very, very good. So there are a few questions which are coming up and a few more which will come by the screen. Probably what I will do, sir, you can stop sharing the screen now and you can come into the main dashboard. So that the question will be visible in the main screen.
Okay. So
I can start pushing the question.
Screen is off now? Yeah.
Yeah, screen is off, sir.
Great.
So
great.
Questions one by one. So participants, if you have any more questions, please go ahead and share your questions. We'll be happy to answer them. A few general questions are being asked. Will these sessions be available even for future reference? I think that we have decided to keep it on YouTube, so you can always refer it whenever you feel like.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so Rakesh is asking a question. I think this is to do with sorting. Instead of flash fill, can I go ahead with delimited option?
Yes, yes, sure, why not? See, in this kind of a data, it was possible to do it using a delimited option also, because, but for that, you know, what you'll have to do is you'll have to first trim the data so that spaces are same, because at some places they had, you know, two spaces, somewhere there was, you know, a single space. So the, yes, you can use the delimited option in this case, okay, primarily because, you know, this data was clean, right? So, but lot of situations you could find, you know, where the data is not so clean. So there, you know, flash fill works better. Okay. But in this case, yes, you could have used, you know, delimited perfectly. But for that, you'll have to first trim the data.
Wonderful, sir. Thank you for that. So let me go to the next question. Okay. Allama Prabhu, sir, he is a former Bangalore branch chairperson and Karnataka State Chartered Accountants Association president as well. So he's asked a question. When we copy the data from web, sometimes all data will be copied in one single cell, you know, horizontally all in one row. Is it possible to convert such data into a columnar format?
Okay, so one way is you can transpose the data. I mean, say I have not seen the data, so I'm not exactly aware, you know, if he's talking about data is somewhere in columnar and you want to, you know, convert it. So one way is you can transpose the data, okay? Or you could also use transpose function, which is there, but transpose function is, since it's an array function, so sometimes, yes, becomes a challenge, you know, using that function. But otherwise, can be transposed, I think so. And from the web, if the data is in the form of a table, then through get data also, you can directly capture the data, you know, through some kind of a query, a web query also, you can, I would say, directly get the data also. So those options are there. But exactly it depends on, you know, what exactly is the requirement. So each requirement would be different. But the options are, number one is you can, you know, like transpose the data. The second option is you can use the, you know, get data option or, you know, that that web query again to get the data directly into Excel. So two options are there.
Wonderful. Thank you, sir, for that. In fact, that get data from web is very handy. I remember once using it for, you know, this HSN rates. All that I did was, you know, put the link into that and I just refreshed it. Automatically the data flows. So that's a very handy option. Okay. Mr. Vikram has asked, how do I delete blank columns or rows in the sheet which are in the middle of the data? Sir, again, you have to unmute yourself, sir.
So yeah. You can use, you know, the go to special option. So go to special option is there where you could select blanks, and using that blank you could delete the columns or rows. Okay, so go to special you could get using the function F5 or Control G, or in home tab, you know, at the right you'll find an option also. So that is one way of doing it.
Wonderful. Please scroll through if any other questions are there. Okay. Okay, Allama Prabhu sir has one more question. When is the usage of delimit option preferable? Sir, again, unmute, sorry.
You know, whenever, see, 99.9% of the times, whenever you are whenever you are bringing the data, Excel itself knows whether it's a delimited data or it's a, you know, kind of fixed width data. 99.9% times, you know, we can go with Excel's choice because Excel today has got a lot of AI built into that. Okay, so delimited option is good, you know, wherever some kind of delimiter is there. Okay, so this delimiter could be a tab or a space or could be some kind of, you know, a character. So there are two things, you know. One is if you have a look at the sheet, you can guess, you know, if there is some kind of a delimiter. Second is if you've got data from somewhere, then probably the way it has been exported, if it has been exported as a delimited data, then, you know, you'll be having, I mean, so you'll have to import it as some kind of a delimited option.
Wonderful. So Venkateswarlu has a question. What is the latest MS Office which has slicers, flash fill, etc.?
Okay, so 2013 is when, you know, flash fill came. Flash fill came with the 2013 version, and slicer also, I think so, with 2013 or perhaps, you know, 2010. I'll have to check exactly, but I think so 2013 has got both, you know, slicers as well as, you know, the flash fill. But at the same time, you know, what I'll surely recommend is, you know, the latest version of Excel is always the best. And if you go with 365, you know, you're always with the, you know, the latest version. So whatever latest features you have would always be there. And second thing, being very honest with you, the cost of technology, or I'll say investment, I won't use the word cost, you know, rather it's an investment, you know, in technology is today not very, very high. If you go to Microsoft, perhaps, you know, for $1,000 or so, you know, if you got 4 or 5 PCs, so you end up paying something like, you know, $1,000 for 1 year, which sadly I'd say any cost to pay for the latest and the up-to-date versions of, you know, MS Office. The benefits are immense because whatever latest features, you know, MS brings in, they all come within, you know, the Microsoft 365. But otherwise, you know, if you got a standalone like 2013, 16, 19, it's equally good. And 13 onwards, flash fill and slicers, all these are there.
Wonderful. So Pallavi has a different question. What is the difference between Excel and R software? So Pallavi, I'll just take a minute to answer this before I give it to Mehta sir. Some more details of this you will get to know through the web series course. Just hang on until then. But Mehta sir, you can answer.
Sure. See, R is a great function to analyze. There is no doubt about it. Okay, wherever data is huge, Excel has a limitation. First limitation is the So Excel has its limitation in number of rows, right? So Excel has got a limited number of rows, whereas R can work beyond that. Okay, now R is solely designed for, you know, some kind of data analysis. So it is in terms of power, you know, I'll say perhaps, you know, R is more, but R has got a much bigger learning curve as compared to Excel. Excel we've all been using, we find it very handy. So for routine usage, yes, Excel works great, but wherever the data is huge and you want to build some kind of models and you want to get a different kind of insights, then probably, you know, R makes sense. Okay.
So this is a compliment to you, sir. Pradeep Goyal.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Shiriz has a slightly different question. So this question is, with lot of tools around like MS Access, Power BI and lot more visualization tools coming up, will Excel become extinct? I like this question a lot because we are talking about today professionals, the way we are working, our knowledge, we should not be extinct. So will Excel itself become extinct, Mehta sir?
Well, friends, my take would be just very simple. Wherever you need a knife, right, you won't be using a gun or a cannon, right? So for simple functions, you know, Power BI won't work. If you want to make a simple calculation or something, you can't do with, you know, something like a Power BI or some such tools. So each tool has got its own, you know, its own usage, right? For small data, for limited data, for, you know, some kind of calculations, Excel works great. But when it comes to huge data analysis, large amount of data visualizations, then definitely Power BI and these kind of tools score over that. Okay, wherever data is huge, again, MS Excel is great, you know, for analyzing huge amount of data. So point is, you know, every tool has its own usage. So maybe, I don't know the future, I can't predict the future, but right now in the near future, I don't think so Excel is going extinct. Rather, what will happen is Excel will evolve also. Just the way we are evolving, you know, we are transforming, Excel will also transform. And, you know, I've been, as I said, been using Excel since perhaps 97 was the first time I shifted to Excel, MS Office, you know, that time. So in this last, you know, perhaps 20 years or 22 years, a lot of transformation has taken in Excel itself. And I think so this transformation will continue. Power BI has its own utility, no doubt about it. At a lot of places, you know, Power BI is a fringe, in fact, a child of, you know, Excel. Because Power Pivot first came in Excel in the version 2010, and then in 2013, you know, Power Query came, and only they are a kind of a byproduct, you know, of Excel. So I believe, see, Excel has its own uses and Excel will also transform. So each of them would have their own usage, you know, in terms of different areas. So that's my take on this.
Wonderful, sir. I really like that statement. Excel will also evolve, just like, you know, reflecting the fact that we as professionals also have to evolve. So the next question, sir, somebody is asking if you can throw some light on dashboards.
Okay, so see, dashboard is nothing, but it's just visualization of data. Dashboard is just a visualization of data and the kind of tools which you use to project some kind of KPIs. So they become easy to read, they become easy to understand. Because management doesn't want to be inundated with numbers. So visualizations are a great tool of, you know, doing it. And Excel's inbuilt features like pivots, pivot charts, and slices. These are three things which could, with which you could make any kind of visualization, any kind of dashboard.
I think this is a overall compliment for the way it is going. Thank you so much. So Mohammed Lakhani is asking a slightly a different question. Can you give us a few areas where we can use these functions?
See, actually something, you know, perhaps we are using on a daily basis, you know, in analyzing data, getting insights. See, my take always is, you know, Mr. Lakhani is a CA or a practitioner. You know, as practitioners, what I always believe is that we should be providing some value to the client. And the value he gets is through insights of the data. And for insights, you know, Excel is a great tool to work. Now, insights could be in form of, you know, since I'm not into, you know, I'll say some kind of GST practice, but in GST practice, I'm pretty sure we can do reconciliations of 2A and all those kind of things, you know, again, using Excel. It's a, you know, great tool with which you can easily reconcile those 2As with, you know, your own data and all those kind of things. Plus, you know, the other areas could be, you know, the regular monitoring of your client's purchases, okay, insights into purchases, insights into sales, okay? Because if you tell your client, these are the areas you need to monitor, these are the areas where you can bring in efficiencies, then probably he'll get a value and he will value you, right? So these two things go hand in hand. If you give a value to your client, then you're also valued, right? So with Excel, you could get insights into data. I would say, see, why should an audit or something be a post-facto thing, you know, after the year is over or so? If you could engage with your client and if you could regularly do some kind of analysis for him, wherein he could get some insights from the data and he could improve his processes, then I'm pretty sure he gets a value, you get a value. Okay.
The next question is, does Microsoft 365 for Mac have the Power BI integration with Excel?
I don't use Mac, so I'm not aware of, you know, the 365 version for Mac. Probably, you know, somebody who's using Mac would answer it on, because I don't use Mac, so I don't have much idea about, you know, how this thing works in Mac.
Vikram is asking, how do I place, say, 10 columns in value field in pivot table at one go? Can we select 5 columns and place 5 or 10 columns and place it?
How to place 10 columns in value field in pivot table at one go? So you can simply drag them into value. Probably, you know, what Vikram is referring is that there are 10 columns. Let's say one is sales, one is, you know, IGST, then CGST, then, you know, SGST, and all these columns he wants to take into value. You can simply drag it. You can simply drag it.
Can I use a flash fill if an order is not followed?
Order is not followed. Probably what Pallavi means is where, you know, perhaps like I take the similar case, unit is later and, you know, that is there. I'll have to check. I don't think so. Because flash fill is nothing but a pattern recognition. Flash fill is nothing but a pattern recognition. So some pattern has to be there. Only then it will be able to recognize the pattern.
This is a question which says, can I use IDEA directly without first using Excel? I want advanced first, then I'll go to the basics.
Yes, you can do it. It depends on the need. You know, IDEA is an altogether different thing from Excel, right? So Excel is more about, you know, where the data is there in Excel. With IDR, data could be anywhere. If you can, it could be through ODBC, it could be through any other means. So IDA has got a different focus as compared to Excel. Both of them are, you know, different. They can be used for audit, there is no doubt about it, but the focus is different for both of these.
Question from Kota Srinivas, sir. He is a former SIRC chairperson. Thank you, sir, first of all, for joining us. So can we use these tools for GST reconciliation between tally purchases and Form 2A? Because that is, I think, one nightmare which most of us have, especially GSTR 2A, where all the inputs are uploaded and I have the data in tally. How do I sort of, you know, reconcile that? So if you could just probably share some light on that.
Yes, surely. Surely, you know, see what we got is two data, and somehow we got to compare them. Okay, so you could have the data from 2A, you could have the data from tally, you can export the data from tally. So then, you know, some cleaning, yes, would be required. You can't just go straight away. Some kind of cleaning could be required, like removing blanks and all those kind of things which you get. There'll be some kind of duplicates also which you'll need to remove it. So, but after that, you know, you could use something like a pivot or something again to reconcile the data. Yes, it can be done. It can be done to a large extent, I'll say.
Wonderful, sir. Thank you. So, Kota, sir, I would also like to tell you, we have two more sessions lined up. One is on advanced Excel, which is going to be tomorrow, and one more on usage of CAT tools. So I think maybe you might get some parts of your answer in the next two sessions as well. So I would request you to, you know, attend those as well. My good friend Padmanabhan sir from Thiruvananthapuram, thank you both of us for the worth watching, even for beginners or for advanced persons. So it is very good. Thank you so much. So this is a good question in terms of pivot. Sometimes the entire data is in the form of numbers. Is there a way to convert the entire pivot from numbers to lakhs at once?
Numbers to lakhs at once. You mean you want those commas to come? Definitely. You go to value field settings. In value field settings, if you go to numbers, so there is an option. What is you know the kind of numbers you want? So there, if you select you know a pattern, because there is an option of you know the format of numbers. So just like you know in Excel in numbers, you know you have an option of that. Of that custom format. So similarly in value field settings also you can give a custom format, so they will be you know formatted according to the format which you know you have selected. So because see what happens is sometimes you take the data into pivot and then you set up some kind of a format and then you do something and that format disappears. Now this happens because it does it afresh. Now to maintain it, what you need to do is you need to go to the bottom, you know, left corner, you'll find an option for, you know, the format. So you go to format, select any kind of a format. So that format will always remain. Perhaps, you know, I believe, you know, that's a question relates to.
Sir, what if the data I want it in terms of thousands and lakhs, assuming I want like, you know, the in the actual table, it is in, you know, up to 8 digits or 9 digits. But I want it in thousands. Is there a possibility for that? That also, is it available?
Yes. See, that is what I'm saying. In custom format, you can, you know, format it in the form of lakhs or, you know, Ks or Ms or whatever. It's all those options are there in custom format. But for that, you know, you need to go to value field settings at the bottom left. You know, you'll find an option of, you know, format. In format, you go to custom and there you can format it, you know, the way you want. So data will always remain in lakhs or, you know, whatever format you've selected.
So this is a common problem which most of us face when we are exporting data. So many a times when you export data from ERP, numerical data doesn't work well. You know, basic mathematical formula doesn't work, etc. So sometimes it's in text format or, you know, something like that. Would you like to throw some light on that, sir?
See, yes, in that case, again, you know, cleaning would be required. So one possibility is through the values function. So with values function, you can do it, or in paste special using multiplication or addition, you know, you need to convert it to some kind of numbers only. Then, you know, the addition and multiplication, all these things will work. So you need to somehow clean the data. So it's a part of the cleaning. And the cleaning could be through either values or it could be through pay special with a zero, adding a zero or multiplying with one. So these are some of the options which are there to clean the data.
This is a compliment for you, sir. Thank you for such enlightening session. It was very crisp and simple to follow. Will be very great if you can have a session for advanced Excel as well in the future. So Abhishek, I would like to inform you that tomorrow's session is on advanced Excel. So please watch out for our updates. This is one question on bank audit. How do I convert it?
See, conversion process is the same, Either you use values field. So one option is you'll be using the value function. With the value function, the values will come. Second option is, a lot of times when the number is appearing as a text, okay, so you get that error thing, So where if you go with convert to numbers, so it gets converted, right? And the third option is, you could pay special. Right. With a pay special multiplying with one or something, okay, it gets converted to the value. So those are the, probably the major three probabilities which are there. But otherwise, if you want to convert, otherwise, plenty of tools are there, additional tools are there, we'll be having a session with Mr. Abdul Rafiq, and Rafiq sir will be telling you, even using ECAT, you can convert it into numbers in one go. So things are pretty easy with these kind of tools, okay? So sometimes, when the data gets stuck or something, you could be using tools, some advanced tools which are there.
We will take the last question for the day. This is a question as well as a compliment. Thank you for the wonderful session. How do I take a pivot table to merge various columns having numbers? When merge these numbers, how do they get added? I'm not too clear with this. Are you able to get the concept here, sir? You may want to throw some light.
But to merge various columns having numbers, when merge, this must be getting added. Okay, so probably, he's talking about, using formulas within there. So yes, there is an option of, using formulas within pivots. Okay, so when you've got different columns and you want to add them. So one way is, outside the pivot also you can do it. Inside the pivot also, there is an option of, adding formulas. So you could build formulas within the pivot also. So if in, ribbon you find, so there is an option of, putting in formulas. So probably he's talking of, merging means probably, different columns are there and he wants to sum them all up or something. So that kind of a thing you could do through formulas, which is there in pivots. Yes, that option is there.
So wonderful. I think most of the questions we have clarified. There are one or two questions which people may still feel it is pending. The reason is because maybe some small bits and gaps might have been there, which we totally agree, because this is the basic components of Excel which we wanted to take you through. And I think Mehta sir, in a very, very simple, lucid language, has taken us through that. So let's wait until the next session, where we are going to go a little more deeper into Excel, and then we'll understand how to use, the powerful tools of CAT tools, which is lined up on Thursday. Friday, we have that's lined up on the next 2 days. And then we have a session on Power BI. Then after Power BI, we have a session on Python. So that's the progress. I'm sure most of you have a copy of this agenda. So those of you are not in our group, please make sure that you join in our group. So we are just giving you those updates there. On that note, thank you so much, Mehta sir. It was wonderful to have you here. It is a pleasure always to listen to you and, learn something. Thank you so much.